everyone, it's Justin again. In this lesson, we're going to learn how to solve one-step equations, and then we'll complete three example problems together. Let's get into it. So, in order to be able to solve equations, it's important that we understand how they're created. If we look at an equation like this, then there is a whole lot going on. But what I care about most is that variable hiding out inside of those parentheses. Whenever we're solving an equation, the goal is to figure out what number that variable represents. But it's hard to think about what that x might represent when there is so much else going on in the equation. My advice is to think about it like a present. Presents are fun and pretty, but what you really want to get to is the actual gift that's hidden underneath all the wrapping and bows. Just like how you have to pull off the bow and rip off the wrapping paper to get into the box to get the present, to find the value of a variable, we need to strip away all this extra stuff that's happening until we're left with just the variable. What we've done here is isolate the variable, which means to get it all by itself. Don't worry, I'm not going to make you try to solve equations like that one just yet. We'll get there later on in the unit. Instead, let's look at an equation like p plus 4 equals 17. P is our variable, and we don't know what number it represents yet. Just like a present, I want to peel away anything extra so that I can get that p all by itself. So, what's happening to the p in this equation to make it 17? Yeah, I'm taking p and I'm adding 4 to it. So how do I get rid of that plus 4 to get p all by itself? Well, I want to undo adding 4 to the p. Almost like I'm trying to rewind time for this equation. How can I undo adding 4? That would be subtracting 4. The reason that subtraction will undo addition is because they are inverse operations, meaning they're opposites. So addition and subtraction are one pair of inverse operations. Do you know what the other pair would be? Multiplication and division. We're going to be using inverse operations a lot every time we solve equations, so this is important to remember. So I need to do something with subtracting 4 here, but surely I can't just subtract this 4 and call it a day. That can't be right. Do you remember our balance scale? Equations have an equal sign because both sides are equal. They have the same value and are balanced, like this equation, with 10 on one side and 10 on the other. So if I want to do something to this equation, like, say, subtract 4. Whoa! If I subtract 4 on one side, now all of a sudden my equation isn't actually equal anymore, because I have 6 on the left and 10 on the right. Well, that's a problem. What can I do to the right side of this equation to keep it balanced and equal? I can subtract 4 on the right as well. So, in order to keep your equation equal, you have to make sure that you always do the same thing on both sides of the equation. Let's recap what we've discovered so far. When we are faced with an equation, we want to figure out what's happening to the variable so that we can undo it with inverse operations. And we have to make sure that we do everything to both sides of the equation to keep it equal and balanced. So let's take another look at p plus 4 equals 17. Right now we are taking that variable p and adding 4 to it to get 17. To undo adding 4, I need to subtract 4. And to keep my equation equal and balanced, I need to do it to both sides. If I put minus 4 on both sides, I wind up with an equation that looks like this. What do you think I could do now? We could simplify. These are like terms, and 4 minus 4 makes 0, so I'm left with just p over here. On the other side, 17 minus 4 makes 13. This is always our goal in equations. We want to get the variable by itself, or isolate it, so that we can see what number it's equal to. In this case, we have that p equals 13. This is our solution to the equation. Now that we have an idea of how to solve equations, let's do a few example problems together. Our first problem says to solve for h in the equation h minus 6 equals 11. Let me bring my equation front and center here. First, I need to figure out, what is happening to h? I'm subtracting 6 from h right now, but I need to undo that. Think about your inverse operations. What will undo subtracting 6? The inverse would be adding 6. So now that I know what I need to do to get that h by itself, I need to actually do it. Remember, this is an equation, so it's balanced right now. I need to make sure that I keep it balanced by always doing the same thing on both sides. Pause the video here and add 6 to both sides of this equation. Does your equation look like this now? That's great. Remember, everything is still equal here because I've added 6 to both sides. Now we can combine our like terms to simplify. Minus 6 plus 6 cancels to make 0, so I'm left with just h here. 11 plus 6 makes 17. So now I have h equals 17, and that's my solution to this equation. I've written my work here on a new line to show how I'm adding 6 to both sides. More commonly, you might also see equation work written vertically. So instead of writing a new line, I could add in plus 6 below each side of my equation, and then combine my like terms from top to bottom. It's the exact same work, so it's all a matter of what you feel most comfortable writing to help you organize your thoughts. The more equations you solve, the more comfortable you'll get. So let's keep going with another example. This example says to solve for k in the equation negative 3k equals 18. Pause your video here and determine what is happening to k and how can we undo it. There's no operation sign here, but remember that a coefficient and its variable are being multiplied. So k is being multiplied times negative 3 right now. I can undo that with the inverse, so dividing by negative 3. Let's solve this together. I want to divide by negative 3, but I have to do that on both sides of my equation. I could write my work in a second line like this so that I can use a division sign, but my preference is to use a fraction bar to represent division and put both sides over negative 3. When I do negative 3k divided by negative 3, I want to divide the coefficients. Negative 3 divided by negative 3 just makes 1. So my left side becomes 1k. If the coefficient of a variable is 1, do I have to write it? No, this is just the same as k. On the right side, I have 18 divided by negative 3, which will make negative 6. Does that make sense? Can the solution also be a negative number? Oh, I know. I can just check to see if this is a solution like we did in the last lesson. I can take my equation and substitute negative 6 for k. Does this make my equation equal? It does. Negative 3 times negative 6 makes positive 18, and that is equal to 18. So yes, k equals negative 6 is my solution. Remember, since we know how to check if a number is a solution to an equation, we can always check our answers for equations. Let's do one more. This last example says to solve for m in the equation m over 10 equals negative 4. Pause the video here and give this whole problem a try on your own. I'm going to start by figuring out what's happening to m, and then how to undo it. Since it is over 10, I know that represents division. M is being divided by 10. So to undo that, I'll use the inverse or opposite operation, which would be multiplying by 10. So I want to multiply each side of my equation by 10. I could rewrite it like this to put the multiplication at the end, but multiplication is commutative, which means it doesn't matter what order the numbers are in. To save space, instead of writing it this way, I'm going to put times 10 out here on the left and on the right. Let's focus on the left side first, because there's a lot going on. We know that multiplying by 10 should cancel out with dividing by 10, but how? Well, since I'm multiplying fractions here, it would be helpful to rewrite my 10 as 10 over 1. Then I can multiply straight across. 10 times m makes 10m in the numerator, and 1 times 10 still just makes 10 in the denominator. Now I could see that 10 over 10 will cancel out to make 1. So this simplifies to 1m. But a coefficient of 1 doesn't do anything. So we could just write this as m. All right, we did it. M is by itself. So let's see what it's equal to on the right. Negative 4 times 10 makes negative 40, which carries down to the end of the problem for a final solution of m equals negative 40. When you finish up this video, there's an activity in your PDF that will help you explore some of the different equation organizing methods to see what you like best. Then you'll move on to your practice game. Sometimes you may find that you can tell what the solution is to the equations just by looking at them, but they are going to get much more complex. So it's important that you use these beginning equations as an opportunity to practice your proper equation solving skills. So be sure you go through the process on each question. Ask yourself, what is happening to this variable? Determine how you can undo it, and then perform that operation on both sides of the equation to solve. Good luck, and I'll see you next time.